So you probably know that on an iPad you can have multiple apps on the screen at the same time. But did you know you can do 3 or even 4? Well, not really, but you can kind of get a third app on the screen and it's somewhat useful. And you could do a fourth app, but there's a big catch to it. So let's take a look at just doing 2. Right? I'm going to go and launch an app. Let's just launch Safari here. Now let's say I want Mail to actually be up as well. So I'm going to drag slightly up from the bottom to reveal the dock, and then I can tap Mail and drag it to the right side of the screen. And now I've got both Safari and Mail up, and I can use them both. I can drag the middle bar to maybe give them 50-50 for the screen. So this is the most useful. 2 apps fully usable on the screen. Of course, it works best with the Apple built-in apps or apps that support this. Some apps, like game apps, require the full screen. But you've got 2. Now can you get 3 up? Well, you may remember there's another way to get a second app up. So I'm going to drag this one off there. And let's say I wanted to bring Mail up instead. But instead of putting it to the right side of the screen, I'm just going to drop it here and it appears as a window. So now it's got this window. I can move back and forth, and these apps are both usable. Now I'm going to drag it all the way off to the right side of the screen so it goes away. I'm going to bring up another app. So with Safari still running, let's bring up the dock there. And let's just say I'm going to bring up iTunes. And I'm going to drag that to the right side of the screen. Now I've got 2 apps there. I can move the middle line, put them where I want. And now I can drag from the right over and Mail appears. Now I have 3 apps on the screen at the same time. Now it's not all that great because notice the 2 apps, the main ones, are grayed out. So in this mode you can't use all 3 apps. You can only use the floating one. And you know, you can still view the information, so that's kind of useful. If I tap on either of the other 2 apps, the floating one goes away. It's still easy to bring it up. So it's very nice if you're waiting for an email to come in or a text message or something, you have the Messages app there, then it's nice to have that. Now how can you get a 4th app? Well, the big catch is the 4th app has to be a picture-in-picture video. So here I've got a video on this web page. If I tap to expand it full screen, because it's a YouTube video, then I get the little choice at the top left to make it picture-in-picture. So now it's a picture-in-picture kind of floating window there. And now I can still bring this floating window there. So now I have 2 floating windows, a video, Mail here in a floating window, and if I tap on the back here, I still keep this floating video window, but I have 2 other apps that now I can fully access. So you can juggle things around and see 4 different things at once. Probably not that useful for the picture-in-picture, but I think it is pretty useful to actually have 2 apps here. Say if you're doing work on 2 apps and you want to bring a 3rd in just to check something really quick and bring it away, it's much better than having the screen go away completely and completely switching to another app.